Today we will discuss about the Hib bond. Hib bond, it is the innominate bond or irregular bond which is the bond of the pelvis. Both the side hip bond with the sacrum, it makes the pelvis, right and left hip bonds. Here hip bond, it is formed by the three parts. The upper part, it is called the ilium. Upper and posterior part, it is called the ilium, and ventral part, or it is called the dorsal part, it is called the ilium, and ventral part, it is called the anteriorly there is a pubis, and the posteriorly ischium. All three bonds which are united at the acetabulums, there is a outer cup shaped cavity, it is called the acetabulums, and it is there is a initially there is a up to the initial life. After the birth, it is the triradiate ligaments, and it is the united at the 7 to 8 years of the age, and it becomes the acetabulum. So it is the acetabulum which is lies on the outer sides, and the ilium on the superiorly and posteriorly, and the ventrally there is a pubis, anteriorly there is a pubis, and the posterior part of the ventral side, it is the ischium. So the acetabulum, which is formed by the 2/3 part by the ilium, 2/5 part by the ischium, and 1/5 part by the pubis. So it is a cup shape. Outer surface, it is a depressed area, and it makes the head of the head of the femur, which is attached, and it makes the hip joints. Ilium has a 2 parts, upper part, and this is the lower part of the ilium. Upper part, and it has a 3 borders, anterior border, this is a medial border, and this is a posterior border of the ilium. It has a 2 surface, it is called the pelvic surface, and this is called the gluteal surface, and it is also called the outer surface or lateral surface, it is called the medial surface. So there are 3 borders, anterior border of the ilium, medial border of the medial border, and the posterior border. It has a 2 surface, pelvic surface and gluteal surface. It has a 2 ends, upper end, and there is a lower ends. So the upper end, it is called the iliac crest. This is the iliac crest, and it divides into the 2 part, ventral 2/3 segment, which is convex outwards, and dorsal segment, which is lies posterior 1/3. So the ventral segment, which is convexity outwards, and the dorsal segment, there is a convexity inside or concavity outsides. So the iliac crest, it divides into the 3 part, outer crest, ventral segment is a outer crest, inner crest, and there is an intermediate area. So the ventral segments, anterior 2/3 part, it is the outer part, it gives the attachment of the inner to the first attachment is the facial artery, and just inner to the facial artery as well as the iliotibial tract, and there is a outer crest, there is a attachment of the one muscles, it is called the external oblique muscles of the external oblique of the abdomen. Only ventral segment, anterior 2/3 part. Intermediate area, whole area, it is the attachment of the ventral segment, it gives the attachment of the internal oblique of the abdomen, and the inner ventral segments, anterior 2/3 parts, there is an attachment of the transverse abdominis muscles, and the posterior 1/3 part. Posterior 1/3 part, this segment, ventral segment on the inner lip, attachment of the quadratus lumborus muscles, and also inner side, there is a inner lip, it gives the fascia transversalis, and most internally, after that, it is covered by the fascia iliaca. Dorsal segment of the iliac crest, outer crest, it gives the attachment of the gluteus maximus, and inner part, it gives the attachment of the erector spinae muscles, and in between there is a posterior layer of the thoracolumbar fascia. There is a in between there is attachment of the intermediate part, it gives the attachment of the thoracolumbar posterior layer of the thoracolumbar fascia. So these are the attachment of the iliac crest. Anterosuperiliac spine, it is the most anterior part of the iliac crest, and it is the gives the attachment of the sartorius as well as the lateral end of the inguinal ligament. Here there is attachment of the inguinal ligaments. Anterosuperiliac spine to the pubic tubercle, there is attachment of the inguinal ligaments, and structure passes beneath to the hip. So the anterosuperiliac spine, there is attachment of the sartorius, and there is a lateral end of the inguinal ligament. This is a posterior superior iliac spine, and this is a posterior inferior iliac spines. So the posterior superior iliac spine, it is the correspond to the level of the if on the both the sides we will draw the transverse line from the posterior superior iliac spine, then it is passes from the S2 vertebra. It is passes from the S2 vertebra. It is the caudal end of the subarachnoid space. The iliac crest, which is crossed by the two main nerves, one is the lateral cutaneous branch of the subcostal nerves as well as iliohypogastric nerve, and there is also a lateral cutaneous branch of the dorsal rami of the upper three lumbar nerves, which is crossed by the iliac crest. Lower end of the iliac crest, which is the end at the it is attached with the pubis, and posteriorly it is attached with the ischium, and it makes the up to the upper margin of the acetabulums, and it is the triradiate ligaments initial up to the puberty, and it is later on fuser, and the upper and posterior part of this triradiate cartilage part, which is formed by the ilium, and posterior two-third part and posterior-inferior two-third part, it is formed by the ischium, and anterior one-third antero-inferior part, which is formed by the pubis. Now the anterior border, which is extend from anterior superior iliac spine, anterior superior iliac spine, then it goes downwards, and then anterior inferior iliac spine, and between the anterior superior iliac spine and anterior inferior iliac spine, there is a gap. It passes the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh. Then the anterior border, after anterior inferior iliac spine, it reach up to the margin of the acetabulums. The anterior inferior iliac spine, it gives the attachment of the iliofemoral ligaments. It attached to the iliofemoral ligaments as well as it is also attached the straight head of the rectus femoris muscles. Posterior border, which extend from the posterior superior iliac spine to the posterior inferior iliac spine, then it becomes converge the concavity. It is makes the greater sciatic notch. It is end up to the ischial spine. This is the ischial spine. So, and then it becomes a continues as a posterior border of the ischium. So, posterior border, it extend from posterior superior iliac spine to the posterior inferior iliac spine. Then it becomes the greater sciatic notch, then ischial spine, and it becomes continuous as a posterior border of the ischium. And posterior superior iliac spine to the posterior inferior iliac spine, this posterior border, which is rough, and it gives the attachment of the part of the sacrotuberous ligaments. And the greater sciatic notch, there is one preauricular notch, it gives the fiber of the piriformis muscles, and this greater sciatic notch, which is converted by the foramen, by the one ligament, it is called the sacrotuberous ligament, and there is a sacrospinous ligament which convert the greater sciatic notch into the foramen. And this piriformis, which is passes from the pelvic cavity to the gluteal region and above to the structure, passes from the piriformis, it is the superior gluteal vessels and nerves, and the structure passes below to the piriformis are the inferior gluteal vessels and nerves. Inferior gluteal vessels and nerves, sciatic nerve, it is the largest nerve, which is formed by the L4, L5, S1, S2, S3. All three segments, all five segments are united, it makes the sciatic nerve. Nerve to quadratus femoris, undercover to the sciatic nerves, posterior femoral cutaneous nerve, inferior gluteal vessels and nerves, nerve to the obturator internus, intercostal vessels and nerves. All these structures which is passes from the below to the piriformis muscles. So the structure which are passing from the great ascitic foramen, which is converted into the foramen by the sacrotuberous ligaments, which is start from the posterior margin of the hip bone, as well as here there is an attachment of the sacrum, ala of the sacrum. So here from the sacrum to the ischial tuberosity, the ligaments which is called the sacrotuberous ligaments, and it is converted the great ascitic foramen into the great ascitic notch into the foramen, and structure passing the key structure, it is the piriformis muscles, above to the piriformis superior gluteal vessels and nerves, below to the piriformis there is an inferior gluteal vessels and nerves, sciatic nerve, posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh or posterior femoral cutaneous nerve, then the nerve to obturator internus and interpudendal vessels and nerves, all this structure which is passes through the great ascitic foramen. Now the now we will discuss the medial border which is start from the pelvic surface of the ilium, and it is the between the ventral segment and dorsal segments, in between there is one border, it is the medial border, and this medial border in a posterior part, it is a or upper part which is rough, and it gives the attachment of the iliolumbar ligaments, it gives the attachment of the iliolumbar ligament and dorsal sacroiliac ligaments. Intermediate part of the or middle part of the anterior border, medial border, it is a sarp, and it is a just behind to it there is a preauricular sulcus and attachment of the, it makes the sacroiliac joint, and the lower medial part or anterior part of the medial border, it is makes the arcuate line and it becomes continuous as a iliopubic line or iliopectineal lines, it is the arcuate lines. So here it becomes the arcuate line up to the iliopubic eminence, and then it becomes the mainly it makes the pelvic inlet boundaries, and this all this line it is called the linea terminalis. Throughout the line, arcuate line along with the pectoral pubis and pubic crest, all this line it is called the together it is called the linea terminalis. So the initial part of the linea terminalis, it is the part of the ilium, it is called the arcuate lines. So and the all this it makes the linea terminalis, which is crossed by the and it makes the pelvic inlet, and it is crossed by the following structure, it is the interiliac vessels which is the it supplies to the mainly it is the blood supplies to the pelvic viscera, ureter, then ovarian vessels, vas deferens or round ligament of the uterus, obliterated umbilical artery and medial umbilical ligament. So these are the structure which are passing from backward to the forwards. So now we already completed the three borders, anterior borders, posterior borders, we have completed, and this is a medial border. Now we will discuss about the iliac fossa. Iliac fossa, which is above bounded by the upper ventral segment of the iliac crest, posterior it is bounded by the medial border, and anteriorly it becomes continuous as a front of the thigh below to the inguinal ligaments, sacropelvic surface, this is called the behind to the medial border, this is called the sacropelvic surface. It has a two part, sacral part and pelvic part. This is called the pelvic part. Sacral part, it has a further two part. It is called the auricular part. It is the anterior part which is attached with the sacrum, and it makes the sacroiliac joint, and it is called the iliac tuberosity. Over the iliac tuberosity, there are three three ligaments which is attached from iliolumbar, dorsal sacroiliac joint and interosseous sacroiliac joint. So backwards to front side there are three ligaments, iliolumbar ligament, dorsal sacroiliac ligament and interosseous sacroiliac ligament over the over the tuberosity of the ilium. So this is the tuberosity of the ilium. So three ligament, iliolumbar, sacroiliac and interosseous sacroiliac ligament. And interosseous sacroiliac ligament, it is the toughest ligament of the body, one of the strongest ligament, and this is the auricular surface which gives the attached to the sacrum and it makes a sacroiliac joint. And this is the pelvic surface of the it is the smooth pelvic surface of the ilium. It becomes continuous as a pelvic surface of the ischium. And on the upper part there is a preauricular notch. It is very deep inside the female. It is the very deep inside the female. Over the this pelvic surface, up at the greater sciatic notch, on the preauricular notch into the upper part, it gives the origin of piriformis, and lower part of the pelvic surface, major portion, it gives the part of the obturator internus. But the obturator internus also around to the obturator foramen, this hole, but it extends up to the pelvic surface of the ilium. Now we will discuss about the gluteal surface of the ilium. It has a three line, posterior gluteal line, this is a posterior gluteal line, then anterior gluteal lines and then inferior gluteal lines. So the posterior gluteal lines, anterior gluteal line and inferior gluteal line, all which is arise from the upper end of the greater sciatic foramen, upper end of the greater sciatic foramen. Posterior gluteal lines which is goes upwards and up to the iliac crest on the junction of the ventral segment, on the dorsal segment, it reach up to the dorsal segment just behind to the posterior superior iliac, just in front of the posterior superior iliac spine. So it reach up to the iliac crest nearly at the junction of the ventral segment and dorsal segments. Anterior inferior iliac spine, anterior gluteal lines which reach up to the near to the iliac tubercle, which reach up to the iliac tubercles, and posterior inferior posterior gluteal line which is reach up to the anterior inferior iliac spines. It reach up to the upper part of the anterior inferior iliac spines. So the area behind to the posterior gluteal line, it gives the attachment into the upper part, it gives the attachment of the gluteus maximus, and lower part it gives the attachment of the sacrotuberous ligament. Between the posterior gluteal line and anterior gluteal line, it gives the attachment of the gluteus medius. Between the inferior gluteal line and anterior gluteal line, there is attachment of the gluteus minimus, and into the below to the gluteus minimus, there is a attachment of the reflected part of the straight head of the rectus femoris muscles, reflected part of the straight head of the rectus femoris muscles. And this is the anterior inferior iliac spine. It gives the iliofemoral ligament as well as it gives the attachment of the straight head of the straight head of the rectus femoris, but reflected head which is arise from below to the inferior gluteal line. So this is about to the ilium. How to side determinations of the hip bone? You have to keep this anterior superior iliac spine to the pubic tubercle into the one anterior superior iliac spine to the pubic symphysis. It is into the one coronal plane. It should be lies. Iliac crest should be into the upper part and posteriorly. The pelvic surface, it is downwards, pubis which is downwards, forwards and anteriorly. Anteriorly and inferiorly there is a pubis, posteriorly and inferiorly there is ischium. Acetabulum, it should be on the outer sides. It should be outer side, anterior superior iliac spine which is facing anteriorly. Pelvic surface, this is the iliac fossa lies on the medial aspect. Iliac fossa lies on the medial aspect. Gluteal surface which is lies on the laterally. So always you have to this is the you have to remember this is the right side of the hip bone. If I will keep this on the left side into the same way, then the acetabulum facing on the medial side. It if facing on the lateral side, then anterior superior iliac spine and pubis, which is goes on the back side. So this is the right side of the hip bone. You have to remember anterior superior iliac spine to the pubic symphysis into the one coronal plane. The pubis which is facing downwards, pubis which is facing a symphysial surface of the pubis facing downwards, forwards and medially, and the acetabulum facing on the lateral aspect. Mainly you have to remember it is facing laterally downwards and forwards, laterally downwards and forwards. It is the facing of the acetabulums. Always you have to remember this iliac fossa. There are two surface, iliac fossa or as well as the sacropelvic surface, which is lies on the medial aspect, while the gluteal surface facing laterally. Ischium acetabulum should be laterally, ischial tuberosity facing posteriorly, and the pubis facing anteriorly. So this is the side determinations criteria for the hip bone. So this is the first part of the hip bone. Hope you will enjoy the about the all the details of the ilium. We will discuss into the next lecture into the pubis as well as the ischium. So this is the part one for the hip bone. Thank you.